we're bringing groups out here. They're even bigger than they were at our fall concert, which is a good problem to have, but we're going to be pretty full tonight. So if you don't mind, just bumping over, scoot towards the middle, or if you're on an end, scoot in towards the end, so that as people trickle in, we can find seats for everyone. Take a moment, please, at this point in time, make sure your cellular devices are set to stun instead of kill. So just check them into airplane mode. That way you can still take pictures, you can take videos, but it's not going to ring during the middle of the show. That's the easiest way. Just pick it on airplane mode. You'll be good to go. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get things started. So we're going to start things off tonight. Gavin Doherty is going to give us the national anthem. So if you would stand up and remove your hat. Here's Gavin Doherty.
This is the concert choir at Sandstone Middle School. So this consists of students with generally little or no experience in singing. So we really hammer a lot of fundamentals, a lot of tight singing, a lot of green rhythms. And so if you were at our first concert back in October, we actually performed some of that for you on stage, did some of the sight reading and that. Today we've got two pieces for you. The first is Winter Song, which is a text is a poem by Emily Bronte, set to music by Audrey Snyder. And the second is actually a rock tune called Santa is the Man. So this is Sandstone Concert Choir. During my life when I was actually not a bad juggler of all things. Comes in handy as a music teacher as well. I'll put it on this side of the lip this time. Thank you. is our chamber choir. So this is open to 7th and 8th graders by audition. So these folks all auditioned last May for the first semester, and then we'll be doing auditions again next Monday and Tuesday to sort out this group for the second semester. So these guys are just coming off of a field trip. We were invited to go down to Salem and perform at the Capitol Building, which was totally fabulous and awesome. But even more fabulous, and what I would really like to draw attention to and make the highlight of that trip, is that every single one of these students showed up at the bus stop at 3:30 in the morning. And what's even better about that is that none of these students have driver's licenses. There are only two people on this stage who drove themselves to the bus stop at 3:30 in the morning. And it happens to be the two people who had a monetary incentive to do so. So if you are a parent or a big sister or big brother or somebody who took one for the team and just carpooled all of the neighborhood kids over to the bus, that I was absolutely shocked. And Sunday was my birthday. This is where you say, like, oh, I didn't know, happy birthday, man. So let's try again. Take two, here we go. So Sunday was my birthday. I love you all to remember. Oh, man. Okay. But anyways, moral of the story is all my family members were calling me on Sunday, and I was trying to tell them, like, dude, I'll call you back tomorrow. I was talking to my brother. He called me at like 7, and I was already halfway asleep, and I was like, I'll call you back tomorrow. I gotta go to bed. It's like, why? Oh, I'm leaving at 3 o'clock on a field trip. Gotta get up at 2:30. And he said, do you know how many kids are just not even gonna come? And I was like, I don't know. And then I went to the bus stop, and it was nothing. So, moral of the story, thank you so much, parents, community members, supporters, because that's just one example, but there's so much that you do for these students to support everything that we do and that my job is about. And what impressed me even more was I saw several of your faces at the Capitol Building to support your son or daughter at that performance. That, if you are that parent, you are my hero. That is awesome. So, thank you, parents. I get to get all, you know, dolled up and be the face that's up here with them. But you are the engine that runs the machine, undoubtedly. So I would, any praise that falls on my shoulders, I would like to make sure that you are every bit a part of that as much as I am. So thank you very much, parents. Our first song is a super awesome arrangement of Jingle Bells called Dashing in the Snow. It's awesome because it changes time signatures 25 times, which means as a teacher, it's great because you get to teach all these cool rhythm stuff. As an accompanist, it's not so great because every measure is in a different time signature. So she's been working very, very hard. It is not an easy tune to play. She is fabulous. Please give a round of applause to Mrs. Parker Whitmer.
Thank you. Thank you. And just a friendly reminder, cheer, clap, applaud your friends, but we don't need to get all crazy with your shout-outs. Let's rock and roll through this thing. No one wants to be here till 9:30. Our next tune is an a cappella arrangement of Carol of the Bells. The last tune that we're going to do with this group is an arrangement of Mary, Did You Know? This is a fabulous song, a brilliant composition, one of my favorite Christmas tunes of all time. And what I particularly love about this arrangement is that it captures the genius of this song is that it's about an infant. And so you're picturing this, you know, super fragile, small, being, and it captures that delicacy, but it also just the power of, you know, this is the Messiah. And so what I loved about this arrangement, and it has so many teachable moments, is that we get to kind of flip back and forth. You know, there's this the delicacy of this little, you know, precious baby, and then just the magnitude of this is the Savior of the human race. So I hope we do this justice for you. This is our last tune. After this tune, we'll take an intermission while we get the risers off and the chairs and stands set up, and we'll be on to the band. This is Tim Hayden's arrangement of Mary, Did You Know? Let's hear it one more time before she escapes for Mrs. Margaret Wendley. All right, at this point, if you need to jump out, use the bathroom, make a phone call, do whatever you need to do, we'll take a 5-minute intermission, we'll get set up for the band, and we'll see you at about 7:33. All right, we start finding our way back to our seats. We're about ready to go on here. So this is the concert band. This consists of intermediate level players, as well as some of our advanced wind ensemble players who are working on doubling a secondary instrument or something of the like. And on that note, I would like to turn everybody's attention to, it's towards the back of your program, I believe. If you open up the inside back cover, it's on the left-hand side there. You will see listed before you an extraordinary number of names. Those are all the students up top that are enrolled in at least one band and at least one choir at Sandstone Middle School. And then down below, we have listed all the students that participate in three ensembles, which means they either get up and come to school at 7 for jazz band, or they take both of their electives and their exploration period with me. There are some students that are in four ensembles at Sandstone Middle School, and that means that they get up early at 7 o'clock for jazz band, and they have both of their electives and their exploration class with me. And there are three students who, as if that wasn't enough, they also hang out for an hour after school to prepare for the Lionel Hampton Jazz Festival solo competition, which we are going to take the big band to compete at. But we also have six student performers who have taken it on their shoulders that they'd like to compete as individuals as well. So things are definitely thriving. I love it because it makes me look awfully good. So if your child's name is on that page, again, I realize that that is a lot for you as a parent. Your student is very involved, but I just want to say thank you for the job security.
Thank you.
So I probably should tell you a story about the trombone section. There was one day in class when I was describing this, we weren't getting the lightness and the feel of it, so I, in an attempt to help us understand the style, I told him it was carousel music, and the trombone section took it upon themselves so that every time we got to that specific spot where the comment was made, to, while playing their trombones, ride the carousel. So I told them that they could do that at the concert, but only if they all got little stick ponies that they could put, you know, between their legs and go, thinking that it was just a clever way of telling them, hey guys, don't do that at the concert. But we have something that almost kind of resembles a stick pony. They tried really hard. We have some like anemic blue horses, but I guess that's what I did. I was kind of asking for it. And there's another section that I need to highlight here. And I need to give this person some props because I've been a bully to them for most of the quarter. So at the start of the quarter, Miss Liz Doherty over here, who's very festive. Stand up, Liz. Okay, that's enough. Sit down. She started playing on a what's called a flugelhorn. Hold it up so I can see. So she started playing on the flugelhorn, and she wanted to, you know, kind of help her chops out. So I told her, well, you can play it in the concert band. She plays trumpet in the wind ensemble. But there are no parts written for flugelhorns usually for concert band. So what I decided to do was I would just give her French horn parts, and she would play it on her flugelhorn. The problem is, those are both what are known as transposing instruments, and there's just this really wacky phenomenon in the band world where, like, if a trumpet player plays a C, they're not actually playing a C. They're playing a different note, but they just call it C. And so, like, every instrument has its own wacky little thing that they call a certain note, and most of the time it doesn't line up. So the problem that Liz has had to go through is that she has to look at the notes on the page. You know, every good boy deserves fudge, and we all know those note names. And then she has to, in her head, play that down. She has to know that the actual note is 1/5 lower, but she is also playing a transposing instrument. So she has to play one note higher than the fifth that was originally down. And it's a lot of work to do in your head. And on one of the first days, I feel kind of bad, but I also don't, because now she's totally awesome at it. But she was writing in, you know, the notes that she was, okay, so here I'm going to play an F, here I'm going to play. So I walked over and I took her music from her and I ripped it up and I threw it away and I gave her a blank one and I made her do it in her head. But so, Liz, sorry, not sorry that I was a bully, but she's totally awesome at it now, and so I just want to bring some attention to the stuff that she's doing is college level stuff. So round of applause for Miss Lee. The rest of them are cool too. Thank you. one more for you here, and then we'll go back and get the advanced band out here. This is called Chanson de Noël. It's basically just a medley of a bunch of theme and variations of the French tune Il est né le divin enfant, which means he is born the holy infant. Thank you. All right, this is our wind ensemble. So this is our most advanced concert band. This, just like the chamber choir, is open to 7th and 8th grade students by audition. They also will be, shortly after Christmas break, auditioning to keep their spots. So it's a competitive every semester. They've got to re-earn their keep. So we will have, it's very good for the program to have that drive under them and get them practicing. So this is the wind ensemble. We've got three tunes for you. The first is Sleigh Ride.
Thank you.
That was All Is Calm. We heard Sebastian Spiva, Amy Wooster, and Gavin Doherty on that one. We have one more tune for you. We are going to collaborate with our principal here on a setting of "Twas the Night Before Christmas," where after each line, the band will play a little 4 or 8 bar interlude of some Christmas song that that pertains to what is happening in the plot. So this is a really fun arrangement. Jack Bullock of "'Twas the Night Before Christmas" with Lori Mills.
Tarnished with ashes and soot. cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. Straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk and laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. Drove out of sight, happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
All right, we got one more group for you here. They're going to play two songs. This is the jazz band we meet before school. This group is by audition as well. So this one is more competitive, obviously, because it's much smaller. So these kids have all auditioned for their spot to be sitting up in front of you here today as well. And these two over here have had the most grueling audition because they were competing for two spots. We're going to feature Zoe Douglas and Aurelio Mary Garavito on Baby, It's Cold Outside.
Thank you.
be a group sing-along. If you look on the inside back cover of your concert program, you've got the lyrics there to Auld Lang Syne. The band is going to play through the verse and the chorus once. The second time, we'll sing it with them, and then they'll play it again to drive us home tonight. So, everybody stand up. Remember, you don't come in right up first. The band's going to play through it once. I'll give you a cue when it's time to get going.
Truck yourself. Wait for me in the bathroom.